year 2009, a bright idea was conceptualized. In 2014, the bold step to actualize it was taken, hence the birth of the Most Valuable Governor's Wife Awards. As former President Barack Obama once said, the single best indicator of whether a nation will succeed is how it treats its women. In accordance with this, the Fulton Company has chosen to celebrate several governors' wives as they have put in their all to see to growth and development in their jurisdiction and beyond. The Most Valuable Governor's Wife Award is not just an accolade to reward nothing, but it is a well-designed leading of a new phenomenon to assess and recognize the governor's wives who have been provided complementary achievements in addition to that of their governor husbands. This assessment is based on their NGO projects available in public domain and focuses on the impact of these NGOs on their beneficiaries. Hence, the shortlist comes from the impact of the projects as seen from the viewpoint of the beneficiaries. The assessment team looks at the sustainability of the projects, its empowerment, impact, the NGO and project as a change agent and corporate branding. All these are put into consideration when awarding the Most Valuable Governor's Wife Awards according to Global Best Practices.
The Most Valuable Governor's Wife Award is designed to lead a new phenomenon in the assessment and recognition of the governor's wives who are making complementary achievements to the governor's achievements. It comes with a set of criteria. You have sustainability, you have empowerment, we have impact, we have corporate branding. We also have like a question, is she a change agent? It is all done according to global best practices. So we now get a set of these criteria, hand it over to an assessment team who will now do their work and hand it over to the awards administrators or the ceremony team.
Fulton Company has realized that no one person alone can build up Nigeria as the country it deserves to be. The realization that we ought to come together as a team, working tirelessly in our own little corners to help strengthen the growth of the country, is the catalyst for the Most Valuable Governor's Wife Awards. Each honored woman is a deserving candidate for the fantastic job they have done in their states and for the versatile beneficiaries. It takes a woman of vision to put together a project and see it through to the end. These ladies were given a platform to effect change as wives of governors, and they have wasted no time in enforcing a better Nigeria with the platform they have been given. However, that is not all. It is also an avenue for these women to work in collaboration on other projects apart from their personal NGOs. When the spotlight is shone on each woman and her contribution, more people who believe in that cause will lend a helping hand. It will also cause intense motivation for those who haven't begun to effect changes around them.
It's like you don't play football alone. You play football in a team. The governor's wife are therefore seen as part of the football team. Some people try to ask that their jobs is not constitutional, it's constitutional. But we look at zoning. Zoning is there. It's the biggest thing that have kept this country together. Zoning is not constitutional. You find out that constitutionality is the application of common sense to doing what is benefiting to the society. The governor's wife in this case are using their own time to contribute to the entrepreneurial development of the citizens of Nigeria at the grassroots, especially as it concerns women and children.
Vision and the whole outreach started as a result of need of the people. Women, in particular in Abuja and environs, were coming to a center called Medicaid for the first time to do their mammograms.
I get this sense of satisfaction and fulfillment when I help the needy.
My name is Barrister Mrs. Amina Oizabello, wife of the Executive Governor of Kogi State. I'm the co-founder of Hyatt Foundation. Hyatt Foundation started in the year 2016 Part of our objective at Hayatam Foundation is to set up a research institute that will continue to research, and the aim is finding solutions. So, of course, that's basically about how it all started.
We give them with delivery kits so that we can help and support them in delivering in a hygienic and safe environment.
The very first award ceremony held at the Sheraton Hotel on the 10th of February 2014, the theme was Grassroots Transformation in Nigeria, the roles of Governor's Wives NGOs as champions. Six awards were given out to the then Governor's Wife of Benue State, Mrs. Yemisi Suswan, Mrs. Ekaete Gozulakpabio, wife of the then Akwa Ibom State Governor, Chief Mrs. Mercy Oji, wife of the then Abia State Governor, Hajia Fatima Shema, wife of the then governor of Katsina State, Hajia Adama Dankwobo, wife of the governor of Gombe State, and last but not least, Mrs. Olufunso Amosu, wife of the governor of Ogun State, for their contributions to humanity and their courage to take the initiative to lend a helping hand to their communities by creating their several foundations. A Lifetime Achievement Award was given to Mrs. Folorunsho Alakija, the founder of Sharon of Roses Foundation and keynote speaker at the event, and received a side award. As May 2015 rolled in, the theme was assessing the contributions of the wives of public office holders in Nigeria. The awards of Most Valuable Governor's Wife was given to four deserving women: Hajia Hawa Abiodun Yuguda, wife of the then Bauchi State Governor; Mrs. Noma Nkechi Rochas Okorocha, Imo State Governor's Wife; Hajia Asmao Abdulaziz Yari, wife of Zamfara State Governor; and finally, Hajia Dr. Aisha Bala Muhammad, wife of the FCT Minister. The Lifetime Achievement Award for the year 2015 was awarded to Her Excellency Honorable Justice Fatih Abubakar, former First Lady of Nigeria and founder of RAPA, was the keynote speaker and received a side award. Although 2016 went by without the award ceremony, due to the time imbalance of the newly sworn-in government, the year 2017 welcomed the ceremony again on the 28th of February, and the theme, the roles of the Governor's Wives NGOs in helping the IDPs in Nigeria. With the awards being given to Chief Mrs. Ebelechukwu Obiano, wife of the Anambra State Governor; Hajia Hadiza Abubakar, wife of the Bauchi State Governor; Dr. Mrs. Rachel Dixon, wife of Bayelsa State Governor; Dr. Zainab Bagudu, wife of the Governor of Kebbi State; Barrister Mrs. Amina O. Bello, wife of the Governor of Kogi State; Hajia Mairo Almakura, wife of the Nasarawa State Governor; and Dr. Amina A. Bello, wife of the Governor of Niger State. The Lifetime Award this year was given to Chief Mrs. Titi Atiku Abubakar, wife of the former Vice President and founder of Wordclef, was the keynote speaker and received a side award. We simply have one Nigeria. There's no other home. Hence the reason why, if anybody is doing much to improve the standard of living, due respect, appreciation, and kudos must be given or shown to those who dedicate their time, resources, and investment into building up this country in their own way.
Well, I feel highly elated for having nominated to receive the award. And I believe wholeheartedly that it's an award well deserved. And I'm very, very happy for her. That's why I'm here to support her.
These wonderful women deserve even more than mentioned, as some of them have been nominated for the Commonwealth IVHES Awards.
We attended to about 3,000 patients, and about 1,000 of them had a cataract surgery and it was removed. Others were given glasses and medication, which I think it went a long way in assisting those people.
I really want to commend you for what you're doing. And I also want to say that it's very important you keep things like this going. Impression about Heart Foundation, you kind of narrowed it down to Keys with Cerebral Palsy alone.
Thoughts, the honor, and the fact that you deem it worthy to not only come and see us, but to actually even consider giving us an award. Therefore, very honored and I'm grateful.
Humbled, honored, I'm excited to be receiving this award. It's a recognition to my modest contribution in complementing the effort of my husband, His Excellency the Governor of Ogun State, in bringing about socio-economic development to the state.
All awardees from the year 2014 till date are very much appreciated and given a huge kudos. As earlier said, the Most Valuable Governor's Wife Award is not just an accolade. It's a form of thanks and a means of pushing others who can to do something.
So, if you look at the international angle of this conversation, you see that there are global first ladies of various countries that have been doing things that complemented the president's achievement. You look at Dame Patience Goodluck with her change initiatives for women. You look at Aisha Buhari with her Future Assured and its component of Get Involved, which is doing brilliantly for the IDPs. You look at Gracia Mandela with her New Faces, New Voices. It's believed that the greatest things that have not been tapped, that remain untapped on the African continent, is women. You look at Michelle Obama with her Let's Move, the anti-obesity program. She was able to talk to Coca-Cola and Kellogg's to reduce sugar content in their products. Look at Cherie Blair with the Cherie Blair Foundation. It's mainly for entrepreneurial upliftment of developing nations. So in conclusion, therefore, this is why we now say the governor's wives are making their own contribution to the development of the society, and they are part and parcel of democracy. You cannot accompany your husband to a swearing-in ceremony and everybody is giving applause, and after that you say her job is not constitutional to make any contribution again to the society. We think we welcome their contributions. Thank you.
The highest common factor amongst these women is maternal and child care, hence the introduction of the proposed award center. This proposed Most Valuable Governor's Wife Award Center, including this maternal and newborn facility, can halt the deficiencies in maternal matters and bring them to zero level. This newborn health technologies featuring new innovative and transformative maternal and newborn needs to the Nigerian women. For donations and support for these facilities, you can reach the project managers on 0816-736-1561 or email mvgw2012@yahoo.com.